we're getting to the last couple sections on what you can do with your channel in your creator studio. Now we're getting to the section called branding. And basically this is where you can add a watermark. And so for a watermark, you want to use a transparent background and you want to use really just one color. So a little logo or a couple letters to represent your channel, and a good size is about 800 by 800 pixels. So what's gonna happen is this is going to appear on all of your videos. You can have a choice whether it's appearing for just part of the time or all of the time. If people are not subscribed to you and they mouse over it, it will prompt them to subscribe. If they are subscribed to you, they mouse over it, it will take them to your channel page. But adding a watermark is something that is definitely beneficial to do. The other thing here is advanced. So your advanced channel settings, this is where you have like your channel avatar that you can change, where you set your country and your channel keywords. Here you can see I can enable or disable offline playback. It's really to allow, like if somebody's gonna be going on an airplane and doesn't have access to the internet, whether they're gonna be able to download and watch your videos. This is also where we allow advertisements along videos and where you can link your account to AdWords. So linking your account to AdWords gives you the ability to pay Google to promote your channel, to advertise for your channel. It also gives you access to some reporting. This is also where we're gonna set up our associated website. So for instance, at Social Blade, our associated website is obviously socialblade.com. Now, if you want to link to a website on your annotations, it's gonna need to be your associated website. So this shouldn't be a website that's not yours. It should only be your website. Here then we have channel recommendations. We do believe that everyone should allow their channel to appear in others' recommendations. When your channel appears in theirs, then their channel may appear in yours as well, but it's always better to be part of the community than not. You can also set whether people can see your subscribers or not. Again, this is personal choice, but I think that you should let people see how many subscribers you have. Most YouTubers, when they come across a channel that hides the subscriber count, they think that the channel has something to hide. They don't quite trust that. So it's much better to show how many subs they actually have. And then down here, you can set up some different URLs and Google Analytics tracking. So those are all the different things you can do with your channel. If you go through and set up all this stuff, then it's gonna make your channel much easier to manage on YouTube.